There must be lights burning brighter somewhere. Got to be birds flying higher in a sky more blue. If I can dream of a better land where all my brothers walk hand in hand, tell me why.
Nick Kyrgios was very honest after his win, now up to 52 in the live rankings with back-to-back victories and back-to-back days. He said Stefanos Tsitsipas is going to win multiple Grand Slams. I can't say the same thing for myself, but if he's playing at this level, it's hard to bet against him.
Yeah, I mean, Kyrgios, listen, he can play on grass. Is he dangerous enough to pick people off? Is he someone that no one wants to see in the draw? Absolutely. Is he a top five talent in the game? Absolutely. Has he proven he can do it in a slam till the end? Not yet.
I just know if I'm serving well and I'm playing well, I can beat anyone. I mean, I have pretty much beaten everyone in the draw before. Not many people have gotten over the hump of winning a slam, you know, and I'm one of the people that has to deal with that every week. Like, oh, he's, you know, probably one of the biggest wastes of talent. Like, he should be winning slams. Like, not many people have actually gotten over that hump in singles. So it's obviously something that I want to get over and hopefully one day. I think I need to focus on the earlier rounds, make sure I get it done as quick as possible.
Did appear to spit in the direction
of one of the people disrespecting me.
Yeah.
Yes.
So that was deliberate to show.
Yes,
you.
I would not be doing that to someone who was supporting me.
Yeah, so there you go. Nick Kyrgios, as I said, there was an opportunity for him just to sort of say, yeah, look, I don't condone that. It's not me. I shouldn't be doing it. But he doubled down. I mean, just because someone was heckling him doesn't mean that person should become the target of his spittle.
You know, I just wanted to remind everyone that I'm pretty good. And I'm so excited to be here again. It's genuinely a tournament. I think it's my best chance to win a Grand Slam, you know, of all the four. So I think, you know, if I just... I'll keep taking it match by match. You know, I've obviously got an incredibly tough draw still. But, you know, today I couldn't have played better and now I can just recover and get ready.
Nick has more matches than me in this court. Well, he claims to like grass, and I think his game is good for the grass. I am definitely thrilled to be facing him. You know, he's I respect him a lot on the court. What he's trying to do, although he has been a little bit controversial in the past, but I think he's playing good tennis. I'm gonna try and concentrate on doing my thing and pay attention to my own game. From start to finish.
Kyrgios.
Yeah, it felt kind of a circus in a way.
Yeah, it's constant bullying. That's what he does.
I don't know what to say. I'm not sure how I bullied him. He was the one hitting balls at me.
I was aiming for the body of my opponent, but I missed by a lot.
Mysteries of our time is how Tsitsipas is emerging as the bad guy.
Yes, well, that's right. He's the bad guy now.
That's the one. Kyrgios has it. Listen to the noise of court one.
It's a default, bro.
Kyrgios has this third set. Has a 2-1 lead.
Oh, le magicien! Le magicien! Oh, deuxième fois, la balle du filet! Et il se dit, Nick Kyrgios!
Got the full Kyrgios experience, including a victory. He's through to the round of 16 and
he can win.
Continues to charge on at Wimbledon.
Well, absolutely. But look, I don't know if you got seatbelts on the couch there, but if you have, strap yourself in, because what transpired after that match is something to behold and something that we haven't really heard from other players for a long, long time.
He bullies his opponents. He was probably a bully at school himself. You don't know what's behind. I don't like bullies. I don't like people that put other people down.
I don't know how it's possible to bully someone in one-on-one on the tennis court at Wimbledon. I thought that my behaviour today towards him, I actually did nothing towards him. I didn't target him at all, or as he was doing to me, hitting balls out of the crowd, that was all on his plate today.
He also has a very evil side to him.
That's just soft. Like, that's just, we're not cut from the same cloth. Like, I go up against guys who, like, are true competitors. Like, if he's affected by that today, then that's what's holding him back. Because someone can just do that and that's going to throw him off his game like that.
Je sais pas ce qui s'est passé, mais Kyrgios, mais qui est cette personne? Ah, du coup, Tsitsipas, et il a raison, Tsitsipas, hein, il se laisse pas emporter. Pas prêt, il se retourne.
I just think it's soft.
Okay, so history will show that he actually went on to win the match and he's now moved through to the fourth round and he is looking ominous.
It's time, bros, I'm going to call you bros now, to find out if Nick Kyrgios is going to win this match and, well, if it's going to be entertainment once again. Let's have a look. Won't accept your silence. Beg me for forgiveness. We'll never get free. Lamb to the slaughter. What you gonna do when there's blood in the water? Price of your greed, your son and your daughter. What you gonna do when there's blood in the water? When there's blood in the water.
Dangerous. Oh,
I need a glass of wine for sure tonight. For sure. So.
Competitors must be dressed in suitable tennis attire that's almost entirely white, and this applies from the point at which the player enters the court surround.
Yep.
Why then would you walk onto centre court with bright red trainers on and do an interview in a red cap?
Because I do what I want.
Do you believe that there is that there is space for that these days in, you know, the gentleman's game of tennis?
I don't know, you guys don't know me at all. Like, you've never actually hung out with me. So, it's a lot of fun. Yeah, people often forget, this is almost my 10th year on tour. I kind of feel like I was the first guy who broke through young. Like, at 19, beating Rafa at Wimbledon, I feel like I was the first young guy to kind of show all the other guys, like Zverev and team and stuff, that they were able to do it as well. I think a lot of players think like Federer, Djokovic, Nadal are almost gods and you can't like hurt them. But I feel like I showed that one of them was human that day.
What a matchup we have in prospect. Nick Kyrgios, the 19-year-old wild card who has taken this tournament by storm, and the man on the other side of the net is Rafael Nadal.
Looks like he absolutely came on this court believing he was going to win this. Oh,
youthful exuberance of bounce from Nick Kyrgios.
That is beyond belief.
It's not a shot of the tournament, it's a shot of the year.
Continues to burst from his chrysalis and gatecrash the elite of the tennis world with a fantastic, nerveless display of scintillating tennis.
I'm pretty happy. That's the biggest win in my career, obviously, and that's something I'm never gonna forget. I'm gonna draw so much confidence out of that, no matter where I play now, to have that under my belt, it's massive. Like, I sit here now in quarterfinals Wimbledon again, and I just know there's so many people that are so upset.
Welcome back to number one court for an eagerly anticipated men's quarterfinal. Gary tossing his head to the skies. A few fireworks.
At a semi-final of a Grand Slam, honestly, I thought my ship had sailed, obviously. You know, I didn't go about things great earlier in my career and may have wasted that little window, but, you know, just really proud of the way that I've just come back out here and with my team and just to be able to put on a performance.
And it's Nadal with a 9-3 lead. And yet again, Rafael Nadal finds a way.
7-5, 7-6.
Somehow, some way. I'm not sure how.
Yeah, obviously it would be pretty special to play Rafa here. We've had some absolute battles on that centre court. Look, there was a time where I was having to be forced out of a pub at 4 a.m. to play Nadal, second round. Like, my agent had to come get me out of a pub at 4 a.m. before I played my match on centre court Wimbledon.
It's a great match, and
you were at the pub last night.
Yes,
Advocation of my conduct warning, Mr. Kyrgios.
Oh! He said he would. He said. Not happy. Not happy.
Why would I apologize? I mean, dude's got how many slams? How much money in the bank account? I think you can take a ball to the chest, but I can apologize to him at all.
And oh, a leap into the air, finally. Oh, he made the volley, are you kidding me?
Why didn't he make more of an effort there?
So many questions, sometimes so few answers with Kyrgios, but he... That's it! Can exhale. He has defeated the danger man. For that, that's a nice exchange in the net.
Grand you thought you could be a future Grand Slam champion.
I'm a great tennis player, but I don't do the other stuff. You know, I'm not the most professional guy. I won't train day in, day out. I won't show up every day. So there's a lot of things I need to improve on to get to that level that, you know, Rafa brings, Novak brings, Roger have been doing for so long. So it just depends how bad I want it, but no, at the moment, I don't think I can contend for a Grand Slam. You know, he's won one against me and I've won one against him. So obviously we know two completely different personalities, and I feel like we respect the hell out of each other though. So I feel like that would be a mouth-watering kind of encounter for everyone around the world. You know, that would probably the most watched match of all time. I would argue that.
Well, unfortunately, as you can imagine, if I am here, it's because I have to pull out from the tournament. No, as everybody saw yesterday, I have been suffering, and that's the thing that I can say now, and feel very sad to say that.
Now, the man tennis fans love to hate has made the centre court final every player dreams of achieving. Nick Kyrgios has been given a free pass through the Wimbledon semi-final into the final, with Rafael Nadal forced to withdraw with injury. As always, where he goes, the unexpected follows.
Here, and I never thought that I'd be playing for the actual men's title. I feel like it's the pinnacle of tennis.
Kyrgios would be the lowest-ranked Wimbledon men's finalist since Mark Philippoussis in 2003, facing either Brit Cameron Norrie or the men's top-ranked player Novak Djokovic, who he's played twice and beaten twice.
I think everyone knows there was no love lost for a while there, but I think it was healthy for the sport. I think every time we kind of played each other or there was hype around it, it was interesting.
We haven't played for some time. I've never won a set of him.
He's done it. Nick Kyrgios has produced arguably one of the greatest performances of his fledgling professional career.
Was an aberration, and that Kyrgios wasn't the real deal, are going to be thinking again about that particular opinion.
But you know, obviously it's just another match for me.
This guy certainly has the talent to be a world number one.
I just feel like he has like a sick obsession wanting to be liked. I feel like he just wants to be liked so much that I just can't stand it. Like this whole celebration thing that he does over the match.
You're doing the boob throw thing.
It's like so cringeworthy. Like it's very cringeworthy. No matter how many Grand Slams he wins, like he will never be the greatest for me. Like simply because I've played him twice, and like I'm sorry, but if you can't beat me, like you're not the greatest of all time.
Off the court, I don't have much respect for him, to be honest.
Unfortunately, someone that's partying with his shirt off during a global pandemic, I don't know if I can take any slack from that, man. That's as bad as it gets for me, man.
We definitely have a bit of a bromance now, which is weird.
Honestly, as a tennis fan, I'm glad that he's in the finals because he's got so much talent.
But, you know, ever since I felt like was almost the only kind of player and someone to stand up for him with all that kind of drama at Australian Open, I feel like that's where respect's kind of earned.
The best tennis he's played is always against the top guys. So that's why we all respect him because we know what he can come up with.
And you'll never probably see anyone who just wins and just plays the game so good, like as a winner than Djokovic. I feel like I'm just a reckless ball of energy right now. I just want to go out in the practice court and hit some tennis balls and just talk and I want it to come already. I want the final to come already.
I was going to say, your first Grand Slam final here at Wimbledon, has it made you hungry for more?
Absolutely not. I'm so tired, honestly.
I definitely need a well-earned vacation after this one. So I'm just really happy with this result. It's probably the best of my career, and hopefully, maybe one day I'll be here again, but I don't know about that. But
Nick, you'll be back. Not just Wimbledon, but in finals. In finals. I really respect you a lot. I think you are a phenomenal tennis player, an athlete, an amazing talent. I mean, you've been hearing all of that for many years. But now, you know, everything is starting to come together for you. So I'm sure we're going to see much of you in the later stages of a Grand Slam, man. And I never thought I'm going to say so many nice things about you, considering the relationship. Okay, it's officially a bromance. All right.